and I'm f***ing tired. Hair tie, chilling with no makeup on. That's when you're the prettiest. I hope that you don't take it on. Wow. Y'all still really haven't told me if y'all are mukbang people or not. Like, do y'all like for me to eat and talk? Because I'll sit up here and eat. But if that's somebody's ick, like, it's a Blossoms world. I'm just watering it. So tell me what y'all want, for real. Hey Blossoms, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Lauren, and I'm f***ing tired. But no, for real, like, I would love to give you my little spiel deal, regular intro. If you want to see what that is, go check out my latest videos. But I don't know, I feel like that gives very much planned, and this video is not planned. This video is just like, I'm tired, you're probably tired, let's talk it out. Like, I'm tired. I'm tired of a lot of stuff, and I think our generation gets really shunned for admitting to fatigue, admitting to being down. It's like, oh, we're babied, we're sheltered, this, we're that. Really, we just broke the very toxic mindset of you have to live to work. We finally are realizing that life is so much more than what we've made it. And I'm so happy, like, I'm so grateful to personally have that mindset of like, there's more to living than doing what I'm doing every day. And I love my job. I have a wonderful job, a social type of job, public service job. I love the people I serve, but I'm tired, and that's okay. That negative side of me keeps trying to invalidate myself by being like, oh, it's your moon cycle time. You're just emotional. You don't have any reason to feel like this. You're not, there's people doing 9-to-5s with 5 kids. You don't have any reason. And it's like, no, I'm not listening to you. Like, you get to be tired and you get to be exhausted and you get to feel hopeless. You really do. But at that same time, I kind of realized like, there's no way in freak that I'm losing hope. You know, like, if there's one thing that I can hold on to, it's the fact that I'm gonna be okay. And I'm going to be where I wanna be. And I think that a lot of that comes with distancing yourself from the expectation of where you thought you were supposed to be now. Like, I had so many expectations of Miami grad school, and every single day, especially of this semester, God has been like, whoa. And I'm like, that's uncomfortable. And so it's impossible to live with no expectations though, right? Because it's like, that's what keeps you accountable. But at the same time, when you release that expectation on yourself and kind of surrender to the ebb and flow of life, you really do get to just be peaceful, because you're not really worried about nothing. And you shouldn't be worried about anything ever, apparently. Because I just found that out. That's something I just learned, is that there's nothing to be worried about. Like, if you're gonna set your feet or plant your seeds, in our case, in our garden, then plant your seeds in faith, babe. There's no reason to keep going back and checking if it's growing, going back and checking if it's getting overwatered. Of course, check in with yourself. Make sure you're still aligned with your goals. But don't steady questioning it. Don't keep going back questioning, like, you sure, God? You sure? You sure? You know? Or it really feels like this isn't the way. I'm done. I'm tired. You know? There is hope. Truly. For me, the way I'm seeing this hope, because that's kind of like the purpose of this video. I'm trying to like let y'all know how I'm seeing hope for myself. And so that first thing came with releasing that expectation and detaching myself from my flaws or my failures. Like, stuff will go wrong and I used to be like, why are you doing this to me? You know, it's more so like, how is this for me? How can I detach from taking that so personal and being like, maybe from a different perspective, this works out for me. I might just be like talking in circles or not making sense, but to me, I really detached a lot from the negative things in my life. And when I did that, I realized most negative things were just because I was taking stuff way too personally. I was being like, there's no way this can happen to me. Thinking it, the world is against you. The world is not against you. And of course, people have struggles, adversity, of course. But there's so much love out there. And that brings me to the point of hopelessness just in humanity. Like, fuck, like, not even seeing a future for yourself. I get so caught up in the fact of, like, what's really happening in the world, in America? Like, damn, it leaves you to think, like, damn, where are we going from here, you know? But my whole thing is, what I kind of have been doing is like realizing it's always been like that. Like, it has literally, we've always had so much bullshit going on in the world. And at that same time, there's always been those positive people, those people with light, those people making a change. And so I can't afford to get wrapped up in the negativity or the thought that, oh, the world is, it'll never get changed. Like, I remember when I first ever started eating vegetarian, and this guy had told me, like, you know, you're not gonna change the planet with that. Cause my whole, I eat vegetarian or vegan meals occasionally or when I can, because of the bad repercussions of meat, the meat industry on the environment, right? And so of course, it's easy to fall in that trap of one person can't change nothing. But if I can encourage another person and they can encourage another person, that's three people off of me making one change. If that keeps happening, it's a ripple effect. And people don't believe in that because we're programmed by fear. And, you know, we're kind of programmed to think like nothing ever changes, you know? But it all starts in your head. And we know these things already. That's why it's like sometimes I'm afraid to come on here and make videos like this, because it's like, you know that. Like, when you tapped in with yourself, you knew that already. You knew that you can be the change you want to see in the world. Like everyone says, like, everything I'm saying has been said before. It's very cliche. It's nothing new, right? But I have the power to create a space on my platform where I talk about it. And if it makes somebody else who never thought about it hear it and they think differently, then cool. That's why people say things over and over. Just don't lose faith in humanity. Humanity is not hopeless. You know, we'll all get right or we get left. Shit. I don't know what to say. But nah, y'all, like, lately just stuff has not been going as planned. And then it's like, what plan? Like, what plan are you following? What plan are you so tied down to that you have to be mad that stuff is not going to plan? There's no plan, babe. I'm telling you, there is no plan made by you. Okay? Just surrender yourself and just move. Just flow. You are fluid. You are fluid. You are fluid. You got it. Whatever it is, you got it. It's already done. We live in a world of fear. You are not fearful. Do not be fearful. Take back your power. Don't fall into those negative thoughts. Because as we all know, life begins and ends with the words on your mouth. Drake said, the power of the mind is not a joke. It's not. So do not give in to that negative self-talk. As soon as you let go of that hope, let go of that belief in self, you have nothing. All that you have is the power of your mind. All that you have is the strength and the ability at any moment to tap back in with self. At any moment, you can tap in with yourself and be like, wait a minute, I'm safe, I'm strong, I'm okay. And that's hard to do. And I know I'm sitting here sounding all calm and zen. Girl, I was just fucked up like 2 seconds ago, literally. I had to call my mom. I don't never call my mom nothing. Okay, so anything I ever say to y'all, I'm really talking to myself. I'm really talking to myself, and those who receive it well, it was meant to hit you. Because I really believe that people that we come into contact with are genuinely just a reflection of ourselves in different forms. So if this message is resonating with you, like, take it to heart. Take it serious. Like, you're okay. And right now, you're not in a space where you can afford to lose hope. Because if it's the one thing that's going right in your life, it's going to be the way you think. It's going to be your mindset and how much you can fucking pull yourself up. And it sucks. I hate picking myself up. I've been picking myself up. And I'm going to keep picking myself up. Also, I wanted to say, like, you have to build healthy habits. And as uncomfortable as that is, you have to. Like I just said, I was just down bad. And as much as I want to go to fucking McDonald's or order a pizza and really indulge in all of those negative behaviors. And the reason why they're negative behaviors is because at the end of the day, long term, it's instant. It's one of those instant gratification things, right? So it's like long term, what's that pizza really doing for me? You know, it just tastes good, which is okay for sure. For sure. But I'm removing myself from, just because something goes bad, I have to make a bad decision. I don't. I want my body to crave good things. I want my body to understand the slow burn, because that's the reaction in life as well. Just like your body does good with eating veggies and fruits in long term, your skin is good, you start slimming down. That's how decisions work in life. Like, life is not instant gratification. You have to be patient. You have to be patient. Slow down and be okay with being slowed down. And I think a lot of us, that's uncomfortable, because slowing down, you have to face your emotions. Or like eating something that's not like the most unhealthy, you have to really sit and be like, this is not touching all my things. Like, I'm still mad. Well, then why are you mad? Why are you sad? Write it out, journal it out. Do something. I'm gonna get out of here. I really just came on here. I was like gonna just send myself, like save a voice recording. That's what I normally do. But I'm like, I feel like I have to stop doing that. Like, I want to share my thought process with y'all instead of keeping it to myself, because at the end of the day, somebody else is feeling this. We live in a too not so perfect world. And what I mean by that is everybody's perfect on the internet because that's what you can be. You can be anything you want on a platform. But in reality, like, somebody's tired. And maybe it's just me. But be encouraged. Encourage yourself. I love you. Bye.